In what appears a cry for help, the regulator of the Nigerian telecoms industry, NCC, has appealed to the Lagos State Government to support its efforts at nipping the prevalent poor quality of telecom service in the board. The reason for the appeal is not far-fetched, as Lagos plays a critical role in the country's telecom sector. About 4 undersea fiber optic cables carrying huge terabytes of data are lying at the shores of the state, from where they are transported to users across the country. Also noteworthy is the fact that Lagos commands more than 15% of the active mobile subscribers in Nigeria.
Telecommunications can only be better with more infrastructure. For example, in the UK, there are more than 65,000 base stations for telecommunication services in a landmass that is far less than Nigeria's. Nigeria is yet to achieve 25,000 installations across its huge landmass. Yet many feel that we already have enough and are facing the environment.
During a courtesy visit to the Governor of Lagos State, Babatunde Rajefashola, the Executive Vice Chairman of the NCC, Dr. Eugene Jua, craved his support to end some of the impediments to good telecom service quality. From multiple taxation to vandalization of telecoms infrastructure, Jua, like a mother hen, protects his chick, seeks protection for the industry he oversees.
Your Excellency, this situation is made worse. There are multiple taxations and regulations that have weighed the service providers at various levels of government, including state governments, local governments, and even some communities.
Fashola, on his part, is not ignorant of the economic impact of a connected society. He, however, differs with Jua on some of the ways of tackling the prevalent challenges.
Whether we like it or we do not, telecommunications and your regulatory role is a multi-jurisdictional responsibility. That is the honest truth. You will regulate the allocation of frequencies. You will regulate bandwidth and so many other things. But you cannot regulate where the towers and the masts are put. You need me, as indeed you need all of my colleagues, to determine where the right of way will be and under what conditions.
Like they say, a man is as good as his word. It is hoped that this meeting will bring about the necessary collaboration that the two must have to overcome some, if not all, of the issues highlighted here today.